1963 was a landmark year for hockey in Vermont. Men's hockey became a varsity sport at UVM, and Gutterson Fieldhouse officially opened its doors. The Catamounts were led by head coach Bill Ruffer in their initial campaign. Vermont went 5-3-2 in its first season, and a new chapter in Vermont athletics had begun. Marshall Stevenson was the captain of the first three Vermont men's hockey teams, and he talked about the pride the players took in what they were starting.
You remember that we were all walk-ons, and we had a lot of pride in the university and the pride in the work that we were doing. We had certainly the passion for the game because at least I'd say towards my second or third year, there were people coming here, young student athletes were coming here specifically to play hockey and get an education at UVM. But they were paying their own way. There were no scholarships then, so it was something that they had to be committed to doing. And I saw that in our first couple of years and some of the games that we had, we'd have maybe 500, maybe 700 fans here, but they were diehard fans.
Lee Roy, Vermont's leading scorer during the 1965-66 and 1966-67 campaigns, spoke about how the team went through adversity to lay the foundation for the future.
I look back and say we laid the foundation or the building blocks for what became a very proud program, a successful program. And I guess they don't know the lumps and tough times that we took in building the program.
In 1965, Jim Cross became the second head coach in program history. Cross developed the Catamounts into a dominant Division II squad in the ACAC. Marshall Stevenson played his final season at UVM under Coach Cross.
He was a taskminder. He held everybody's accountable to what they were doing on the ice and off the ice. I thought sometimes he worked a little too hard on some of the ice activities, but I also realized that the dividends paid off in the end, and I think his record proves that.
Coach Cross took an innovative approach to the game. He was an early user of European systems and even allowed Leroy to try something unique at the time for the college game.
My shot was so bad and so weak that I convinced Coach Cross to allow me to try a curved stick. Now, most people are gonna say, what's he talking about? But up and through 1966, all we ever knew was straight sticks, and all of a sudden in the NHL, they were using curved sticks. And I thought, God, it can't hurt me, maybe it'll help. So Coach Cross allowed me to be the first player to use a curved stick for the varsity program.
There's no doubt that Cross's approach worked. In 1970, the Catamounts defeated Bowdoin 4-1 to win Vermont's first ever ECAC Division II championship. Ted Yates was a freshman on that championship team with his older brother, Jim.
I think Jim Cross just recruited the right people. People were good leaders, worked hard, had skill, and I think every year, as I said, the team got better. More better players came in every year, and it was just a cohesive group. Everybody worked together. Plus, we had Dave Reese in goal, so that helped a lot.
Over the next four seasons, the Catamounts posted an unbelievable 64-8-1 record in ECAC play and collected two more Division II titles in 1973 and 1974. The 1974-75 season brought a new set of challenges for the Cats as they joined the Division I ranks of the ECAC. From a 1-6 start, Vermont carved out a remarkable 24-12 record and finished third in the league after its first ECAC tournament appearance. Coach Cross told the New York Times upon his retirement that he, quote, wouldn't trade that first year in Division I for anything. Cross retired following the 1984 season after leading the Catamounts back to the ECAC tournament in 1979 and 1980. His 280 career coaching wins are a UVM record. Mike Gilligan then took over the helm, becoming the third coach in program history. He discussed what makes UVM such a special place.
If you are part of UVM, you're part of a pretty interesting family that really bleeds green and gold. And the experience to me is much, much different than being at BC and BU and some of these campuses where the hockey nuts know you, but nobody else tends to know you. Up here, if you are on an athletic team or you're a coach, you're an important person to the community. And you have to, I think you have to live as such. And it's a weight when things are tough, when the season's not going well, and it's an awful lot of fun when things do go well.
It was a lot of fun for the Catamounts in the late 1980s. In 1987, St. Albans native John LeClair was selected 33rd overall by the Montreal Canadiens in the NHL draft. LeClair stayed in Vermont to play for the Catamounts, and to this day, he remains the highest NHL draft pick in UVM history. Ted Ryan, who has covered the Catamounts for the Burlington Free Press since 1975, talked about what a special player LeClaire was for Vermont.
Well, number one, of course, John's talent was enormous. But obviously the fact that he was a local boy, he grew up in St. Albans, he played at BFA St. Albans, came here to use the second NHL draft pick to play for UVM, second out of the state of Vermont to play after Toby Duclon. And with his skills, the way he played the game, that he could dominate a game at times, clearly made him a huge favorite. And of course he went on to a career, but that extra bit of being one of our own here in Vermont certainly elevated him to that elite status among UVM hockey players.
In 1988, LeClaire's freshman season, the Catamounts made their first ever NCAA tournament appearance following a 21-win campaign. The following year, in 1989, Coach Gilligan and the Cats reached their first ever ECAC title game of the Division I era. Vermont trailed the eventual national champion Harvard Crimson 2-0 midway through the third period, before senior defenseman Jeff Shulman keyed a Vermont comeback with a shot from just inside the blue line. The Catamounts rallied to defeat Harvard 3-2 in overtime. Coach Gilligan at the time discussed the resiliency shown by the team that day.
It's anytime you can beat Harvard any place, it's a great game, Tony. The kids never gave up. They did all the little things. They certainly showed a lot of character coming back from the deficit the past couple of weekends. So I give them a heck of a lot of credit. They're a great group of kids.
Ian Boyce was the captain of the team that season and talked about the influence that Coach Gilligan had on him.
You know what? He was a great coach. He was a player's coach. You know, some of the guys will know that I obviously enjoyed playing for him a lot. He pushed you hard. He demanded a lot of you, but I also think he knew and got a lot out of his players and respected what we were able to produce on the ice. So I was in his first recruiting class. I feel honored to be part of that class. And as I said before, just a tremendous person and mentor.
1993 All-American Aaron Miller echoed those sentiments.
What he did for me is he gave me confidence. I really don't ever remember him coming to me for making a mistake. He was just get out there and go. And I played a ton, and I just gained so much confidence playing for Coach Gilligan. And for that, I'm truly thankful.
In the mid-90s, the program reached new heights as Coach Gilligan brought in a trio of future All-Americans.
It was such a privilege and such a pleasure to watch Martin Saint-Louis, Eric Perrin, and Timmy Thomas for every game I think I saw over their 4 years here. And I can remember Coach Gilligan talking before they even arrived on campus, how much excitement, how great Perrin and Saint-Louis were going to be. And I think it was like, two shifts into the first game I saw, you knew this was something special. It was tremendous because you knew they were in every game. The way they played, the intensity they played, but also the sheer love of the game, the excitement they brought. Whenever they went down ice, you saw the crowd go move to the edge of their seats. They were anticipating all sorts of things. And yet at the other end, you knew Tim was there to make some great saves. And as many people have seen with his time with the Boston Bruins too, he was an orthodox. So he made it just as exciting at one end as Eric and Martin could make it at the other end. It was just a fabulous combination of things, and with some great role players behind them. That has to be remembered, that with those other players behind them, gave them the support to be able to go out and do what they could do. Just tremendous.
In the 1996 NCAA tournament, the Catamounts won their first ever NCAA tournament game, defeating Lake Superior State 2-1 to advance to the Frozen Four for the first time. And although the Catamounts fell in double overtime to Colorado College, it was a remarkable season for Vermont hockey. The team won 27 games, a Division I record, Tim Thomas was named ECAC Goalie of the Year, and Martin Saint-Louis and Eric Perrin both set the single-season scoring record with 85 points. In 1997, the Catamounts earned their third NCAA tournament berth. St. Louis left the program as the all-time leading scorer with 267 career points. And of course, all three of the All-Americans went on to win the Stanley Cup in the NHL.
I mean, those 4 years at Vermont was some of my most fun years in hockey. The community, the college atmosphere, you know, the old gut, it's a pretty good barn to play in. So I had a lot of fun there. I have some dear friends still there that I like to go visit. So. Vermont will always be a special place for me.
In 2003, Mike Gilligan stepped down as UVM head coach after 19 seasons, just like Coach Cross. Gilligan accumulated 279 wins in his tenure, just one shy of his predecessor. Kevin Sneddon, a 1989 national champion while a player at Harvard, was named the fourth head coach in program history, and he knew what a special opportunity it was.
I was a former player at Harvard, former assistant coach and head coach at Union College. I've been coming to UVM for 14 years and always thought this was just the best place to play college hockey, the best fan base, best community. And when I had the opportunity to look at the job, it was just an honor to even be considered because it's such a, you know, the traditions of the program and the history of the program, the great coaches like Jim Cross and Mike Gilligan. For me to be even mentioned in the same breath as those two was truly an honor. And to have the opportunity to coach, a program that represents the entire state of Vermont was a dream come true.
Coach Sneddon guided the program as Vermont transitioned to Hockey East in 2005. Jamie Seifer served as team captain for Sneddon's first 3 years at the helm.
You know, I learned pretty quickly about the history and tradition of the program, and it was something he definitely wanted to follow. So I saw it as, you know, a lot of commitment and a ton of hard work. And you try to keep up with that for 4 years, and it eventually shapes you as a player and as a person. So I still use, you know, a lot of the things I learned here in my college days and now in my professional career.
Torrey Mitchell was a part of Kevin Sneddon's first recruiting class at UVM, and he talked about his experience in Burlington.
It's great. You know, it's an opportunity of a lifetime, I think. You know, you're part of a brotherhood. You come here and you're not sure what to expect, and you build your life, you build friendships that you're going to hang on to forever, and it's just a great experience.
During the 2007-2008 season, Vermont started to leave its mark on Hockey East. The Catamounts hosted and won their first ever Hockey East quarterfinal series, defeating Northeastern en route to a first league championship game appearance. Kevin Sneddon was named the Hockey East Coach of the Year that season. Heading into the 2008-2009 campaign, Sneddon knew the Catamounts had something special.
Well, I think first and foremost, the cohesiveness of the team. We had great leadership, and we really just played as a family. Everybody accepted their roles and embraced the challenges that we had throughout the season. And it was just a lot of fun to be around that team. And you knew it was a special team from the moment we started that season, and it was just an incredible journey, one that I'll certainly never forget.
All-American and Hobey Baker finalist Victor Stahlberg led Vermont to a team record 15 Hockey East wins as the Catamounts cemented their fourth NCAA tournament appearance. The Catamounts earned their second Frozen Four berth with a win over Yale, followed by a thrilling double overtime affair against Air Force. As it had before, Vermont followed up its Frozen Four with another NCAA tournament appearance the following season. Jay Engtel scored an overtime winner against UNH in the Hockey East quarterfinals, propelling the Cats to their fifth NCAA berth. Kevin Sneddon, who began his 11th season as head coach of the Catamounts this year, has had a great run at UVM. Sneddon's teams have advanced to the Hockey East or ECAC tournament in 9 of his 10 campaigns, and he entered the season with 147 career victories. Vermont hockey has been a source of pride for this state and this university. Vermont has had 21 players named as All-Americans, 4 Hobey Baker finalists, 5 NCAA tournament appearances, 2 Frozen Four appearances, 48 NHL draft picks, 14 NHL players, 6 Stanley Cup champions, and 11 major NHL awards. It truly has been 50 years of excellence.